Could this be the perfect place for a moon base? Did you know that more than 200 pits on the moon could be used as future moon bases? These pits in the moon meet several requirements to house human settlements. But how are these lunar pits formed? How deep are they? What would the lunar bases that could be built on them be like? Keep watching to find out. Forming the pits on the moon is a complex process that is not yet fully understood. The pits are believed to be formed by a combination of volcanic and tectonic processes. The most accepted theory is that these results from volcanic activity on the moon millions of years ago. During this period, the moon was a geologically active body, and there was a great deal of volcanic activity on the lunar surface. Some of these volcanoes were large enough to form impact craters. Over time, volcanic activity subsided, and the cavities created by the volcanoes cooled and contracted, resulting in pits in the moon. This theory gains strength if we compare the wells on the moon with those produced on Earth due to volcanic eruptions. According to Arizona State University scientist Robert Wagner, the pits could form when the ceiling of a cave collapses, perhaps from vibrations generated by a nearby meteorite impact. However, there is little evidence to point out to a particular cause. The pits could be created when molten rock flowed under the lunar surface. Lava tubes form on Earth when magma flows under a solidified crust and drains away. The exact processes could occur on the moon, especially in a significant impact crater, the interior of which can take hundreds of thousands of years to cool. After an impact crater forms, the sides collapse under lunar gravity, pushing up the crater floor and perhaps causing magma to flow below the surface, forming the pits on the moon. Exploring impact melt wells would determine the nature of the pits in which they form. They are also likely due to melt flow into the pond due to lifting the upper layer after the surface has solidified. To date, the team has found more than 200 pits spread across the melt ponds of 29 craters, which are considered geologically young Copernican craters less than a billion years old. 8 wells on the lunar Maria, 3 of which were previously known from images from the Japanese Kaiguya orbiter, and 2 cuts on high ground. The similarity between the pits on the moon and those on the Earth resulting from volcanic eruptions is enormous, which is why many scientists believe that within these wells, there could be vast networks of interconnecting underground tunnels. However, so far, no structure with these characteristics have been found. Pits on the moon can vary in size, shape, and depth. Some wells are small with diameters of only a few meters, while others can be several kilometers wide. The depth of the wells also varies, with some wells reaching depths of several hundred meters. 3 of them were first identified using images from the Japanese Kaiguya spacecraft. Hundreds more were subsequently found using a new computer algorithm that automatically scans thousands of high-resolution images of the lunar surface from the spacecraft's narrow-angle camera, NAC, Lunar Reconnaissance Satellite, NASA Orbiter. Features of pits in the moon. Pits in the moon have several unique features that make them attractive to scientists and space exploration experts. First, the pits offer natural protection against radiation and extreme temperatures on the lunar surface. This makes them potentially useful as lunar bases, as astronauts could live and work in the pits with less exposure to radiation and extreme temperatures. Another exciting feature of the pits is that they can contain water ice. Some pits have been found to have much colder temperatures than the surrounding lunar surface, suggesting they could contain water ice. Water is a precious resource in space exploration, as it can be used for oxygen production and as a source of hydrogen for propulsion. In addition, pits in the moon may also contain valuable information about the history and formation of the moon. Scientists can study the materials found in the pits to learn more about volcanic and tectonic activity on the moon and how it has evolved. Return to the moon, this time to stay. Since humans first set foot on the moon more than 45 years ago, the scientific community began to explore the possibility of creating a lunar base where humans could go to the moon and stay there indefinitely. But this poses several challenges, which could be solved if we use pits in the moon as underground bases. One of those wells could be this one. This crater was recently discovered in the Mare Tranquillitatis, famous for being the landing site of the Apollo 11 lunar module. This crater is 400 meters wide, or 1,312 feet. In this image obtained by Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter, it can be seen that the crater has a smooth surface at the bottom, and the roof protrudes from the walls, which could indicate that it has a large covered area that is not visible from space. This is extremely important for the future of lunar missions, since according to estimates, the temperature inside this type of pit could only be 17 degrees Celsius. Remember that the moon is highly inhospitable, with temperatures ranging from minus 173 degrees Celsius to 127 degrees Celsius, and constant solar and cosmic radiation exposure. The lunar surface is also covered in fine dust, which can damage spacesuits and machinery. Also, the moon has no atmosphere, so there is no protection against high-energy particles that can penetrate the surface. Building underground lunar bases in these craters could solve many of these problems. Being below the surface, the bases would be protected from radiation and extreme temperatures, and safer from meteorite impacts and solar storms. In addition, the construction of underground bases could allow the use of local materials, such as lunar regolith, moon dust, for construction, reducing the number of materials that must be transported from Earth. However, building underground bases on the Moon is complex, and several technical challenges must be addressed. Technical challenges of building underground bases on the Moon. The main technical challenge of the construction of underground bases in the craters of the Moon is the regolith cover that covers the entire lunar surface. Most likely, it is that in the craters, the regolith is concentrated in more significant quantities, possibly several meters thick, which means that any excavation must begin with the removal of this layer. One option is to use robotic excavation machines to do the digging work, which also presents challenges. Excavation machines must be robust enough to survive in the lunar environment and be designed to operate in extreme conditions of low gravity and extreme temperatures. In addition, the machines must be capable of transporting the excavated material out of the underground base without polluting the air. Another challenge is the provision of power for the underground base. Solar power is a viable option on the lunar surface, but sunlight only reaches certain areas in craters. A simple option to solve this is to use nuclear reactors. However, this presents security and transport challenges. Perhaps the best alternative would be to place solar panels in the areas most exposed to the sun's rays. Building underground bases on the Moon also presents construction and transportation logistics challenges. This requires many materials from machinery and equipment to supplies and food for the workers. These materials would have to be transported from Earth, meaning high cost and logistical effort. Another challenge for astronauts will be communication. A base inside a crater would not allow radio signals to enter or exit in many directions, only upwards, which would be a problem since a geostationary satellite would have to be placed first that always points to the base so that it has communications at all times. Despite the technical and logistical challenges, building underground bases and craters on the Moon could offer many benefits. For example, shielding from radiation and extreme temperatures would allow more complex and prolonged scientific experiments to be carried out on the Moon. In addition, the underground bases could be used as storage depots for materials and supplies, reducing the amount of material that must be transported from the Earth. Using the pits as lunar bases. The use of pits as lunar bases has both advantages and disadvantages. One of the main advantages is the natural protection they offer against radiation and extreme temperatures. Another advantage is the possibility that the pits contain water ice, which would be a valuable resource for space exploration. The water can be used to produce oxygen and as a source of hydrogen for propulsion, allowing astronauts to stay on the Moon for extended periods and carry out more ambitious missions. However, some disadvantages are associated with using the pits as moon bases. First, the pits can be challenging to access and explore. Most pits are several kilometers deep, making exploration and material transport challenging. In addition, the pits can also be dangerous for astronauts. There may be hidden hazards, such as cracks or areas of weakness in the ground, that could risk the safety of astronauts working in the pits. In addition, the lack of sunlight in the pits could pose additional challenges for the exploration and work of the astronauts. Despite these drawbacks, pits in the Moon remain an attractive option for moon bases. Additional research and studies are underway to determine how the pits can be used safely and effectively for space exploration. Investigating lunar pits is essential for the future of space exploration and the possible creation of lunar bases. Despite the challenges in exploring and utilizing pits, their possibilities are exciting and promising. Ongoing research and study of pits on the Moon will help us better understand their formation, characteristics, and possibilities of use for space exploration. With perseverance and dedication, we are one step closer to discovering and harnessing the full potential of the Moon.